subscribe button to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Everyone, this is Dr. Raghuram Sharma here. We are going to study prelims psychological abilities and mains ethics paper. This was actually introduced previously in UPSC long ago on the name of same psychological abilities in prelims in UPSC. Later, it is a bit difficult to give multiple choice questions in psychological aspects, because all the almost four answers will be similar. You need to find out the right one actually according to psychology or according to ethics. No one right answer will be there. It depends on perception. Sometimes one A answer might be right, sometimes B might be right. In such cases, all the four answers will be right. It is a bit difficult to give multiple choice questions in prelims. So they removed it. And from 2013, it was introduced on the name of Ethics in Civil Services Mains for 250 marks, where 125 is for theory and 125 is for case studies. So that's fine, that's going on. Let us come to the state now. In APPSC, in BED, etc. courses, we have psychology. But the psychology related to child psychology, like pedagogy, etc. But that is related to only education field up to teachers only. But now, when we are applying for group 1 posts, where more number of people will be working under us, more number of problems will be solved by us, for which our capacity should be more high intellectually. In general, we might be facing many situations where we deal it with ease. Like two friends will be in problem, will come to you to ask a solution. Hope you experience these situations. Two people will be fighting to each other, they'll come for a solution. At the time, you know how you feel? You'll feel yourself like, okay, I'm a hero, I'm a leader, I'm a problem solver, I'm a decision maker. Okay, for these two people, we'll do something. Whether it is right or wrong, problem will be solved. Our confidence levels will be increased. Yes or no? Do you ever observe this? Unknowingly, our ethical concern will be developed a little, unknowingly. But people who observe this are needed for group 1. My emotions will be in my control. My anger will be in my control. Do you ever observe? Father will have angry. Will he show it? In general, in every home, father will have angry. Does he have anger or not? Actually, he'll not have angry. He'll enact as if we will be in our control. Who got emotional control now? A father got emotional control. He is a leader of a family. If you are going to get into civil services or this state civil services, it means group 1 services, you will be like father to a department, leader to a department. What do you need? Emotional control, which is very important. Call it as emotional control. Okay. So, for which, to get that, to possess that emotional control, you need some process of control on emotions. It is not an easy task. In some situations, we don't know how we are. We lose our control and we burst out like anything. We abuse people. If possible, we'll threaten them, or else we'll get into depression. Either we express it, burst it out, or else we'll get into depression. Anything may happen, which we call as intrinsic and extrinsic. Our emotions are two types. One is intrinsic, which happens inside. Second is extrinsic. We'll show it outside. We express this outside. We burst out. So among all these things, we need control. Who got control on self are considered as leaders. So these leaders are important. Do you know something? We love somebody who knows everything. Yes or no? We love somebody who speaks us excellently. Yes or no? We love somebody who knows everything. We love somebody who got command on everything. We love people who got everything. So even government want the same people who knows everything, who got everything, who can control everything. So they are selecting those people only who got control on psychological aspects of self and others. Who can control self and others are required. So that's the reason from this year the concept psychological abilities were introduced in group 1. What it is expecting? A perfection. A perfectionist. A person who got perfection on himself and others, who can solve anything. I'll give you a small question. You people completed your engineering. Maybe it's a case study. You can solve it. You people completed your engineering. You are excellent in it. Government, some prime minister called you to his office and asked you to please complete a project of Nagarjun Sagar Dam, which is not actually existing. How many are capable of doing that? You complete your engineering, you are master in it. How many can do that? It depends on situation. It depends on person too. You know why? For that we need self-awareness. Mere upar mujhe bharosa chahiye. I can do that. Yes, I can do that. Yeah, what's wrong in it? Constructing a big dam is okay. However, we do it architecturally, we'll plan it. If we implement it exactly over there, it will be done. Is it that easy to give a statement? How much confidence we need when it is possible, when we have self-awareness, capacity. When we know about our capacity, we can do that. When it is possible, when we have psychological abilities. So we need to understand those situations and we should understand self and try to implement it perfectly. For that we need again integrity, self-respect, motivation, etc., empathy, many things comes into it. But we need to have control on self. That's the reason they are asking this psychological abilities, to have perfection, to know about others, to know about the situations, etc. To deal with every aspect of life, we need that. Like, what is this? This is a brain. It is divided into like memory, speed, creativity, attention, focus, flexibility, etc. Telusuma kavalo chestunna. Okay. So we have all these things in our brain, but what we are focusing on, are we have control over it? Are we doing it? We need something. It's not working. So we need something of managing all at a time. Are we capable of? We are before examination. Do you have confidence that you are aware of everything to go to examination confidently? In general, 98 people will be in stress. 98% people, students will be in stress. They might be forgetting hall ticket. They might be forgetting pen, pencil or rubber or something. Somewhat they will be tense, they will be sweating. But 2% people will be there. Who will go to in examination with ease. You know why? They are aware of themselves that they don't write anything. So those people will be so confident. Whatever they ask, I can't write. So I can go, I can just write it down, just go and come. Okay, the result is the secondary issue. Whether they pass, they fail, secondary. But the situational. Ethics only comes when there is a situational problem. If not, it doesn't matter. So psychology also the same, situational matters, the situation, what is your answer? So that's the reason it is asking. Okay, the next one. In group 1 prelims, we have this emotional intelligence as syllabus, okay, which is very important. Understanding and analyzing emotions, this is important, emotions, underline the word. Entire prelims runs on the word called emotions. We learn what emotions are, what is intelligence, and how we combine together dimensions of emotional intelligence, from where we can perceive emotions up to where it concerns. My sound has a limit, yes or no? It may pass up to this room. Can you expect this up to Gandhinagar or RTCX roads? We have a dimension. Emotions also will have a dimension. After that, we can't do anything. So developing the emotional dimension, for which we need to know the boundaries. Okay, next, coping with emotions. At some time, I'm influenced by some other's emotion. Do you know something? If someone laughs, I laugh. If someone cry, whether you know, you experience, even we'll cry. If someone is sad, even our happy mood will go in ruin. Yes or no? If 10 people are laughing and smiling, one person came to us with a good cry, will all people laugh continuously? Will change their mood into sad. Okay, when we are influenced by others' emotions, we'll be in so stress. At the time, what we should do? I think you met with some people in the society. When you are dull, they'll come to you. They are not influenced by your emotion. They are not sad. In spite of that, they'll in return motivate you. Tell that nothing better, don't try, get up, do it. Don't stop, you should go. They motivate us and we don't know. We'll be out of our emotion and we'll go on our work with a good spree. Yes or no? Do you ever observe that? Some people will never get influenced by emotions. You know why? They are more emotionally intelligent than us. Then only it is possible. If not, how to cope up with emotions is also very important. Okay. Empathy and coping with stress. You know what is stress? Someone will be, what we can say, crushing the brain. Can you please lock the door, please? Close the door. Someone is crushing the brain. We'll feel that pain in the brain is called as stress. We are unable to move, we are unable to take decision, we are unable to sense the body. Lot of difficulty in the brain which leads to depression is called as stress. How to come out of it? I think which are very important in our life, you know, not for examination. Next. Social intelligence. How to behave in a society. Interpersonal skills. Knowing each other excellently. Decision making. In different situations, we may not be able to take decisions clearly. At the time, how to take decisions? Sorry. Next, critical thinking. What is criticality? What is critic? Please. Actually, the paper or the session or ethics paper is not a theory. It is actually a practical paper for which we need to interact more. As much as you speak out, that much as I can explain more. So what is criticism, criticizing, etc. What is this critic? Pardon? Please tell me, nothing wrong. Thinking in different dimensions is called as criticism. Thinking in different perceptions. Okay, if it is so, if it is like this, why can't be like this? Okay, if there is two dimensions of this aspect, why can't we think in a proportionate other dimension? Thinking in this way is called as criticality. Vimarsha, we call it as vimarsha. Thinking it in a different way. Okay, and problem solving. When you can solve problem, when you have critical thinking. If there is no go, there is no way from these two paths, how can we go out? We think critically, we'll get out a solution, we'll solve the problem. So for which this is base. And assessment of personality. This is a very important and crucial aspect which we need to learn. Many people think that we all are excellent in these aspects. Do you know that? We feel we are excellent in these aspects. But actually we are not that excellent. In situation, we may be missing many things. In situation, we might be missing many things. It is not easy, sir. Thinking excellently and doing something wonders is not possible. We may watch movies, but we can't enact like a hero in our real life. Yes or no? There might be a situation you might have observed, but which you faced in the recent times. Can you solve the problem in the society? Two politicians are fighting. One home minister and chief minister. A hero went through and did some magic, and he is an assistant to a home minister. Within a 1 month time, he become very important person to chief minister, and he fell in love with the both daughters of both CM and home minister. And later on, he just took a revenge. Is it easy? So forget about the movie. I'm speaking about a situation of a person. Can you do it in a real life? Actually, so if you find some situation like that, what will be your opinion? What will be your option? That's ethics. He might have done it, but that might not be a right option. Some other right option might be there. Think of it critically, then you will solve a problem for which you need to assess a personality. Few people are there before me, I need to assess everyone. I need to assess my father. Is it not required? I need to assess my mother. I need to understand her pain and agony. I need to understand my friend. I need to understand my relatives. I need to understand the society. Then only dimension, the limit of boundary of my thought will increase, will go to the society. Even in society, colonies are there. After colonies, city is there, more district is there. For development of your thought, development of your boundary, you need to assess many people, or else you will be in a trouble of being cheated. Yes or no? How many will cheat you? Okay, it's a wrong question. How many times you are cheated? Generally, everyone will be cheated. Even me, everyone will be get cheated. That's not a bad thing. It's a genuine thing. It's a natural process. How many were cheated many times? We all got cheated. If we assess a personality excellently, is it possible? Can we get cheated? Percentage will be reduced. May not be 100 times, but maybe 20 times will be cheated. 80 times will be protected by self. What it gives? Assessment of personality. So which is very important. The next one. In group 1 mains, forget about it. Entire syllabus of UPSC was given here. Okay, within 4 chapters. Marks might be around 40 to 50. But entire syllabus is given. But except few. Ethics, human interface, in which essence, determinations and consequences of ethics, dimensions of ethics, ethics in private and public relations, role of family, etc. Human values, what are human values, how to attain it, how to identify them, how to attain it, and where we can use them, gender equality, etc. Next, attitude. In UPSC, there is aptitude. It was not given. Now it is only attitude. Attitude is, what is attitude? Very good. Behavior. Okay, behavior, how we present ourselves is attitude, pravartana. Okay, so where in society, in social groups, at home, at institution, in organization, in industries, where how we behave in different sectors, areas is explained. Next, concept of public services, code of ethics, RDI, why they bring all these laws and policies, how it is useful to people, whether we are in a capacity of bringing them to people or not, assessment of self, etc. These are the things for mains. So this is syllabus which represents exactly what we are. So if you learn this excellently in a good way, you will present yourself like a good human being to a good society where you can deal with bad people also. There are two people, right? Good people and bad people will be there. Okay, you will be good to the good society. And you are not that easy go person for bad people also. Because we are able to estimate the personalities. We are able to assess the personalities. We are able to think the problems before itself. We can prejudice. We can think. We can critically think and solve the problems. We have decision making. We have a personality and character of decision making. Yeah, no one will cheat us. There are many great people who are perfect in all these things. So this is actually syllabus for ABPSC group 1. Okay, so mainly for passing through we need mains, prelims. So we can think of mains later. First, prelims is important. for which emotional intelligence is the basic source for prelims. Emotional intelligence and social skills. First of all, what is emotional intelligence? According to Daniel Goleman, a great scholar of psychology, okay, who wrote a book called Emotional Intelligence, EI, it matters than any other thing. He wrote a book called EI, that is Emotional Intelligence, in 1995. Till then, the world don't know the word called emotional intelligence. We have emotions, we have intelligence, but together there is no word called as emotional intelligence. Okay, we have emotions or we have intelligence, but together EI is a word started by Daniel Goleman. Previously, there are two people, one is John Mayer and Peter Salovey. Two scholars are there. I think it is better to write John Mayer and Peter Salovey. Both are research scholars of psychology who started research on this emotional intelligence, EI. Later, I think they are around in 90s, Daniel Goleman, wrote a thesis called Emotional Intelligence, It Matters. The world came to know about emotional intelligence through him. Now we are able to do it in examinations also. It becomes such an important thing as if everyone in corporate sector, like MNCs, etc., are applying this emotional intelligence as a workshop for their students and trying to develop the intelligence levels of their employees. Emotional intelligence got that reputation now. Okay, now, you know what he's told? Read it. If your emotional abilities aren't in your hand, if you don't have command on your emotional abilities, if you don't have self-awareness, what is happening in me, whether I'm feeling, how many felt hunger? Do you felt hunger ever? There's a question here, because if we get tiffin in time, breakfast in time, lunch in time, dinner in time, water in time, we will not feel hunger. We feel like something is empty, okay, we need to just fill it with the stuff, we fill it. We are not feeling hunger. Do you ever felt hunger? Do you know the pain, how it is actually? What indications will go to the brain if you are feeling hunger? Knowing that is called as intelligence. Okay? Knowing about emotions of brain, if you are more hunger, you will feel more angry, irritated. Okay, if you have full of your food, if you fill your stomach, then you will feel satisfied. What is this satisfaction? Is an emotion. Happiness is an emotion. Anger is an emotion. Lust is an emotion. Love is an emotion. Nothing wrong. There will be no abusive words in subject. Okay, for person to person in conversation might be wrong words, but in subject no wrong words will be there. In psychology there are no wrong words at all. Okay, so he speaks, if your emotional abilities aren't in your hand, if you don't have self-awareness, if you are not able to manage your distressing emotions, sometimes anger might be distressing me, sometimes overjoy might be distressing me, sometimes my cry, my sadness might be distressing me. If I don't control on them, if you can't have empathy and effective relationships, showing empathy towards others, feeling. What is empathy? There's a small quote called walking in other shoes. What is walking in other shoe? A beggar might be wearing some shoe. We don't know the pain of it. Generally, we feel like, okay, he's also wearing chappal. Once you wear it, you'll come to know how many holes are beneath the shoe. How many nails are poking his palm. When we'll come to know? When we'll come to know? When we wear them. Okay? So, having that focus of others' experiences is called as empathy. Once again, having the focus of others' experiences is called as empathy. If you don't have empathy and you have no better relations, effective relations is everyone comes to you for problem solving, everyone will come to you to have a good word with you, Generally, we go to people, you know, some for motivation or for some guidance, for whom we go, for that moment, we'll be so happy and the positivity will continue for a week. Do you find some people like that? Yes. Those people are still existing. If you don't have those effective relations, if you are not like that, next sentence, then no matter how smart you are, no matter how smart you are not going to get too far. After writing a thesis on emotional intelligence, this is a statement he gave. If you can't hold your emotions, if you can't control your emotions, if you don't have empathy, if you can't experience others' feelings, your intelligence and smartness will go in vain. Nothing happens. You can't go too far. You are not going to get success. So what we need? Control of emotions, empathy, having good effective relations are important. So emotional intelligence will give you all these things, benefits of society. That is what ABPSC is expecting all intellectuals along with emotional intelligence. By writing all the other subjects, you will get intelligence. By reading this paper, you will get emotional intelligence. Why we need, why are we writing examinations, boss? Please be clear. Why are we writing examinations for getting a post? It is true that we are writing examinations for a post. But actually, we should write this examination for? There will be two things always. One is an important thing, one is makeup. What is the makeup here? We are writing examination for our position. What is the core value of this examination? Serving public. Serving public should be the main motto. But for which many people are competition. To face that, we have this examination process we need to pass through. So you should have more, what we can say, more effective power, what we can say, sankalpa mantangada, willpower should be to serve public. If it is so, then all the subjects will be very easy and you will have ability to face the consequences. After getting in the position, what will be your job? There is a blame on government employees. They always sit under a fan with AC, with a happy luxurious positions. Is it happening? Actually, is it happening? Few might be there, but many are working their jobs, doing their duties excellently. We are interested on those positions, not these. If it is so, this examination is suitable for you. You are eligible to sit in that position. So we should not forget the core concepts. What is our core concept? Serving public. Once again, serving public, public should be the main motto of getting into the position, not to earn money in different manner. You'll get money, however, after sitting there, you'll forget about the situations, you know. You'll start loving people, start serving public, because you will get respect from the other side in the same way. Okay, so this is what he says. Next one. Okay, in prelims we have psychological abilities. I don't want to prolong it because subject is little deeper. Okay, I'll go with a little slow, in emotional speed, as if you will understand the core concepts of this and what we are going to study in the next classes. Emotional intelligence and social skills, both are there, two chapters. Why emotional intelligence matters? Tell me, why emotional intelligence matters? Is it required? Why ABPSC is conducting this examination on emotional intelligence? Why it is required for you, any one of you? Gattiga, chappo, sorry? To interact with? Each other. For that, do we need emotional intelligence? Communications are enough for that. Why emotional intelligence? If they are explaining, you can understand, no? If I am explaining you that, sir, I am feeling hungry, don't you understand my hunger? Then? Fine. That's a good answer. Okay, if I tell you that, sir, I am feeling hunger, you can bring a bread for me and I'll eat it. Hunger will be satisfied. Okay, Anna? Pardon?
We'll be working under some bureaucrats.
Okay.
And if the situation arises where we could not make a decision, which we think it works.
Okay. When we are working under somebody, when they pass us some situations, for that understanding properly and bringing out a good solution or decision. Okay. Next, sir, somebody is speaking there. See, nothing wrong, okay? When you are in classes, whether you study here or somewhere, keep something, a point in your brain. You are one in your position, you are speaking to one. Okay? Iddare unno ankonni, then it's actually beneficial in classes. If you feel that someone is there, so this is also psychological weakness. So don't feel that, okay? So nothing wrong in speaking. If it is wrong, we'll correct it. If it is right, we'll appreciate it. That's it. Okay?
Other emotions feels our emotion.
Once again, other? Pardon? Loudly. Nothing wrong. You said it's right. Please.
Other emotions
feels
our emotion.
So, fine. Knowing about emotions of each other. The thing is, I'll come to your same point. I communicated that I'm suffering from hunger. It's a question, feel it as a question of FBSC. Someone came to a superintendent of jail, group on post. I came to him telling that, sir, I'm suffering from stomachache. What will you do? Array, are you suffering from stomachache? I'll call the doctor, I'll make a checkup and all, I'll do it. I communicated, he understood. For which emotional intelligence is not required. That's fine. Whatever you need to do, you did. But actually, if I told wrong, if I lie, sir, I'm suffering from stomachache, which is actually not feeling, how can you understand whether it is fake or right? How can you understand whether my stomachache is existing or not? Without knowing the actuality, reality, if you bring the doctor, you will become. So, emotional intelligence will train you whether the other person is speaking truth or false, whether he is right or wrong, then how to react. I'll tell you a small example for it. It's a question again. I think you might have faced it in previous demos or somewhere. You are a deputy collector, group 1 post officer in a district. You got a phone call telling that, sir, in Srikakulam district near Parvathipuram, there was a huge train accident. Two trains met with each other and collapsed. A lot of damage and destruction was happened. What will be your answer? Answers might be different. What will be your immediate action?
Call subordinates. And I'll just know if it really happened or not.
Okay, next. Rescue team. Okay, happened, I told. Rescue team. Sir. Intelligent people will do this. Nothing wrong. Intelligent people will search for all the options, whatever is possible. They call the doctors, they call the ambulance, they call police, they call rescue team, they call the station masters and they give signals, they call labor and ask them to just gather their work. But emotional intelligent person will not get panic. This all will happen when we feel panic. You know what he do? What he does? First he'll ask the question whether the trains are passengers or goods. Why? According to the accident, if passengers are there, we call it as health issue. Medical issue. We need medical assistance. So I can call to the doctors or hospitals to bring ambulance. If it is a goods train, do I need to panic? Okay. I call some other person to just take care of it. Health and life is more important than any yes or no. So for which what I need? It matters. Emotional intelligence matters. EQ can lead to healthy relationships and have ability to respond to the challenges of one's life and carry it in a positive manner. If I feel panic of a situation, what about my subordinates? Sir is in tension, so we need to work out. They'll work in the same tension. So I'm influencing my emotion on others. It leads to destruction. So we need not do that. Next. What is EQ? Everyone will have. IQ is intelligence quotient, how we project ourselves, how we speak, how our body language, how we deliver our lectures, how I walk, how my dressings are. This is IQ. EQ is not seen. See, there is an ice cube here. Okay? That is called as emotional quotient, which is known only to you, not to the other eye. That's what is very important. Who are you? It's a question. How will you answer? You tell that, sir, I'm the son of X, son of this, and brother of this. Is it a right answer? Who I am from inside is the right answer. I am capable of constructing anything as an engineer. I can do any favor for the public up to what extent I am concerned. If I feel it real, I can go to any extent for the sake of public. Who can tell this? Can I tell that he is an excellent person in speaking? He is an excellent person in dressing? I can tell all this. Can I get into the brain? Can I tell that his ability of repairing something is excellent? Can I tell that? No. Internal abilities will be known to self. So we need what? Self-awareness, self-regulation, self-management, etc. So those are inner abilities which are not seen. These are not seen. Only this is seen. 25% of our personality is seen, not the others. Emotional intelligence is key to professional and personal success. Capacity to understand the self and others' emotions. This is very important. Understand self and others' emotions. This is the only key of life to get success. Remember. Do you ever observe a small children supports each other? Do you ever observe? Do you ever observe a youngsters after 30 to 40 age will support each other? Why? What is missing here? Children are supporting each other. Animals are supporting each other. Why not human beings support each other when there is a crucial situation? No. Position matters. We are driven by the needs. What is your need now? If your need is always to serve the public, please understand, if your need is a very required thing to my brain, is called as need. If your need is to serve the public, you will not get diverted. You will do the same facing any circumstance. If your need is to get position, you will not bother about the society. You will not bother about the pain of others. You will achieve it. What is your driving mode? What is driving you? Whether the serving public concept or getting position? In MNC, again it comes under emotional intelligence. In MNC, multinational company, there was an examination conducted on behavioral aspect. Telling that for position, we are checking you for this entire week. What people will do? Will come to office in time. Will work more time. Generally people not do that. Should not do that. Should come in time, go on time. Should come on time, should go on time. According to Abdul Kalam, should not come in time, go after time. Work in time. To impress people, what we do? We'll come in time, we'll go after time, and we work more. We'll escape lunch, we'll escape tea, we'll work more for the people for 1 week. Yes or no? Why we are doing all this? This is driving for promotion. So what I am doing? I am forgetting everything, escaping my own actual needs, and my other important need is driving me towards something negative. After getting promotion, actually you will lose all these things. Once you get a promotion, you need to escape tea, you need to escape lunch, you need to go late to the home. Actually it happens after getting promotion. What I am doing to do? Showing? What I am showing? I am ready to do all these things. I can escape all. You proved that I am ready for that. Because that is driving me. I can escape my family. I can neglect my family. Can we do that? Professional and personal success is very important, sir. If your personal success will not satisfy, your mind is happy with personal success, not professional success, you will not be happy. If you are success outside but not success inside, will not give happiness, satisfied. You should be happy at home. Happy at your workplace also. For which you need to maintain emotional intelligence. I should not take my work of office to home, because I need to spend my time with my kids. You might be youngsters now. Okay. You can think only for examinations. After getting married, you'll have such an ability of thinking about the society and family also. Then what you will do? Now you have only one motto to satisfy the examination. Or the government, or the working place. At later time, what you will do? You need to satisfy home. You need to spend time with your wife. You need to spend time with your kids. You need to spend time with your parents who are old. Then how it is possible without emotional intelligence? You need to maintain things in a better way for which we need it. Okay? To understand the self and others' emotions. Discriminate. Okay, I'll ask you a question in ABPS. I'll ask you a small format. Your son's birthday in the evening. Your son's birthday in the evening. You promised him a time of 6 o'clock for cutting of cake. Okay? Around 2:30 in the afternoon, a village people, Gram Panchayat people, came to you telling that, sir, we too have a problem of caste. Two people are fighting for on a caste issue. They wanted to speak to you regarding this. So we need your time. When you are going to give me time? They tell that, sir, tomorrow. No, sir, they are dying now. If you solve the problem today, people will have a sound sleep or else there will be a bloodshed. Okay, sir, when you tell me your comfortable time, shall I come now? No, sir, people are not ready. For this arrangement, I need 3 more hours. I think around 6 to 7 is a very probable time. You come at 6 o'clock, I'll make arrangements of people to sit together and just we'll have a discussion. If you are there, issue will be controlled. If you are not there, issue will not be controlled. Sir, please, we request you to come and solve the problem. What will you do? Is it not a cluster concern situation? What will you do? You have a 5-year-old kid who got more expectations that father is coming to home for my birthday party. Sir, this is also emotion. The child heart should not get broken. Can you allow it? No? Can you live a caste issue in a society where there is going to happen a bloodshed? So what will you do? Rush to? Spot. What will you do here? Will you break the time of 6 o'clock to attend a birthday party? If you don't go here, the child heart will be broken. If you don't go there, many heads will be broken. What is important? Heart or head? Head. Both are important. How can you solve this problem? You gave promise of birthday party around 6 o'clock for everybody. It is not about only your son's concern. I go at 4 o'clock, jaldi aa beta, cut the cake, have it, bye bye. Can I go? Even if I do so, the heart will be broken again. How can we solve the problem? Convincing? Convincing child? Very good. Can you convince the child? Can you convince your same equal brother or mother or wife? I think you might not have experience of all those things. Actually, it's a very big difficult task. Let the world die. Do things to the family. Then look at the world. So, things will be like that. So it's fact. What can be the solution? These are things will not happen, work out. You know what the answer is? The answer is, a person who is facing this problem should be emotionally intelligent. He might have prepared his family previously that if there is any situation, if I may not come to home, you should not feel bad. Hope you understand the point? If there is a war today, can I make arrangements of all the soldiers to get ready? What are we doing? We have army, we have navy, we have air force. Why? We are prerequisite concept. We are ready previously if there is a situation to respond. You should be emotionally intelligent to train your family that if there is any harsh situation where I can't attend the home, you should be able to manage. I should train my wife. I should train my kid that your father is a social person. His first duty is to work for public, later the family. I'll definitely come to you. If there is a situation, if I can't come to you, you should understand. I should train my son. If it happens previously, now, is there any problem for me? I can go happy there. I can solve the problem. Not the 6 o'clock. I can come back by 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. I can spend the whole night with my son. I can play. Child anger will be for a moment, you know. That will be satisfied with a small chocolate or a small balloon. Can satisfy them. What can I do? I can bring more balloons and more chocolates as a gift to my son. He'll be satisfied. Even if I come late, he'll forget that. So what we require? An emotional intelligence to face the consequences. So that leads. So discriminate the, and recognize different feelings, distressing feelings, which are distracting me. I need to have emotion and control on that. We use emotion from guide behavior. Manage emotions to achieve goals. These are the important things. And what is emotional intelligence? Balancing the both heart and a mind. Sometimes we will think like a person came who is so close to me. You know, with what I speak? With my heart. If there is a person who is critical, I'll speak to him with my brain. So to some people I'll speak with my heart. To some people I speak with my brain. But emotional intelligent people will combine the both and speak such that they'll be always in a safer side to solve a problem. So combining heart and mind is emotional intelligence. Okay, there's a small question here. Read it. Rekha, how do I look in this blue dress? Sanjay, you certainly look good, but I still feel red suits you. Red suits you better. In general, we are in trap outside. How is my hairstyle? Are super, excellent, mama. Even though we don't like, we'll appreciate for his happiness. He'll come to know what you are. Actually, you are cheating self. Can I tell frankly that your hairstyle is not good? Can we communicate it frankly? No. What is better? How your emotional intelligence should work? Look at here. We are not hurting others, but telling frank. Rekha, how do I look in this blue dress? Sanjay, you certainly look good, but I still feel red suits you better. What he did here? You are looking good, but red is more apt for you. Now, the answers are, is he discouraging Rekha? Is he being critical? Being tactful? Being optimistic? Now, this is a question for MBSC. Tell me, what is his behavior now? What is his feeling of emotion now? See? He is optimistic, very good. How many are A? Okay, how many are B? No, how many are C? 1, 2, 3, very good. How many are D? Many. What is optimistic? Having a feeling of insight to look positive. What he is doing? He is expressing. It means what he is doing? He is tactful. He is speaking with tactics. You are looking good, but red suits you more. He expressed it. He used his words. The answer is C. He is being tactful. So in this way, we need to understand a situation without hurting others. We need to answer. So this is a question. Okay, so what is IQ and EQ? Why emotional intelligence? Why emotional intelligence? Well, we need to maintain brotherhood at workplace, betterment of behavioral aspects in our neighbors, being good with everyone, okay, upbringing the productive levels of our colleagues, etc. There are qualities for emotional intelligence. Understanding and analyzing emotions are very important. The second bit, we should understand things in a better way. Okay. Okay, another question. You have gone to a nearby shop to purchase some grocery and after purchasing them, you realize that you came to know that you forgot your purse, wallet. Your neighbor has also come to purchase something from the same shop. In such a situation, it would be better if you, what you will do? Request the grocer to deliver goods at your residence. Please, send it there, I'll give you money there. Request your neighbor to act as your collateral. Sir, even you tell that, sir, please, even I forgot purse. I can ask her also, no? Please, tell that, even I also forgot purse. To protect self. Accept to the grocer that you don't have any money with you, but would pay him later. I'll give you later, please, send it to my home. Borrow money from your neighbor and pay her later. What will be the suitable answer here? You know, in psychology, I already told you beginning. What? There will be no one right answer. According to mind, according to situation, according to perception, according to person, answers might be different. But focusing on something, what is actually is important. If you plan for 100 questions, na, you'll be a great emotional intelligence scholar. For 100 questions, we need to answer. If it is the second one, what will be your answer? A, request a grocer to deliver goods at home. Okay. After paying money, ask him, he'll do it. Before paying money, if you ask him to send, empathy, understand others, how painful it will be. Stand at that position, what will you do? Next. Request your neighbor as collateral, sir, mera purse ko gaya, please, aap bhi bolo, aisa purse ko gaya, bolke, dono milke leke. Is it okay? No. Accept the grocer that you don't have any money with you, but would pay him later. अभी तरकारी घर भेज दो, बाद में पैसे दे दूंगा, हो जाएगा? भेजेगा, लेकिन कैसा भेजेगा? How will he send? With happy heart? No. Borrow money from your neighbor and then pay her later. Neighbor घर के पास, she stay besides me. What can I do? If you have money, please pay it. After going home, I'll give you money. What is better? B. So, in mind there are two things. Bhavavesh, jaldbazi. We'll do something which leads to mistakes. The other thing, with a cool mind, if you think something, it will give better results. So, the second thing is always important, emotional intelligence. Okay, in this way there are many things. Dimensions of emotions, in which is a very important thing. Self-awareness, self-regulation, this comes in dimensions of emotions, how to understand it. Social skills are explained. Coping with emotions, I already explained what is coping, coming out of stress, emotions, etc. Okay, this is stress mind, should come out of it, should feel pleasant. How? Empathy, understanding others, okay. So, etc. So, in this way, we have syllabus followed by an ethical concern. What is an ethical concern? Understanding people in a positive way. When we are working in a government, we are working for public. So main motto is to understand public. So all the policies of the government should be reached to the public. And we should understand the examination points of view, because this is also very important. Having vast subject is a part, and writing with good strategy is also another part. So how to write statistically, strategically, and how to answer questions in a better way to get through the examination to serve the public is also very important. So that's the reason ABPS is conducting this examination, to bring, I already told you, the perfectionist who got control on emotions, who got sound subject, and who can do everything. So we should be like that. For which we need this paper along with other papers. So other papers are theoretical, this is actually practical. So have sound knowledge on it. Okay, and have positive attitude and be optimistic, and you are going to crack it. You are going to crack it when you have this optimistic behavior, psychological ability. This is to control your emotion, whether I'll do it or not, I'll do it or not. I can do it, will bring you more positive results. Okay, I'll do it or not is a doubt. I'm going to do it, will give you more positive results. Okay, so thank you very much for listening to the class. Next, I think you have economy class followed by. So thank you very much.